Hi everyone, thanks for tuning in again, and I am here with one of my favorite singer-songwriter musicians from the Aspen Snowmass area. This is Suzanne Paris.
Hi!
Suzanne, thank you for giving me a few minutes of your time. I've been following Suzanne for a very long time, and whenever there's a venue here, I just love to come see you, and I just want to ask you a few questions if you wouldn't mind.
Sure.
So one of the things I want to ask Suzanne is, what inspired you to become a musician?
Well, when I was little, you know, my family lived in a very small little place in Texas, and there was no room, extra room for my little bassinet, and it was next to the stereo in the living room. So when I was 6 months old, my dad loved music. He played the drums, and he just used to play music all the time. And I remember right away just being able to hear the harmonies. And I just was like, oh, that's easy. I can do that. And I don't know, it made me happy. It inspired me because it made me happy hearing music and knowing that I might be able to do that. And then the Beatles were the biggest inspiration because I could just hear everything they did. And I thought, oh, that'd be fun.
Well, Suzanne, I love your music, and I've been listening to it for so long. And Suzanne's music really makes me happy.
Oh.
You know, it really moves my soul, so I get what you're saying.
Aww.
And the next question was, who inspired you? Now, you mentioned the Beatles. Who else was an inspiration for you?
The Beatles, well, there was quite a few people, but Stephen Stills is my favorite guitar player when I was learning guitar. And then a lot of English musicians, like Nick Drake, John Martin, The Who, The Stones. I just always liked that sort of energy, and I guess I was born at that time, you know, around that time when that was what was happening. And I mean, they were much older than me, but that was what my little ears heard, and I didn't hear that it came from America to begin with. I didn't know that. So I always liked that, and Led Zeppelin, too. So I kind of have a rock and roll inside thing that's been pretty, pretty on the outside, you know? But then when it comes down to it, I just want it.
I love it. We walked in tonight. We were at the Limelight Hotel. We heard some Stevie Nicks tonight. We heard some great stuff. Stuff that just, like I said, moves my soul. And what would you recommend to an aspiring musician? Because he has so much passion. I started playing guitar, and I have a long way to go. But I love music. Like I said, it moves my soul. So what would you give to an aspiring musician?
I'd say choose the person you like the most, or people, artists, and just sit there and listen to it over and over and over and over and over. And try to sing to it and copy it exactly like they're doing it. And play it exactly like they're doing it. And that's what teaches you how. Then after that, you can take off from there and sort of learn your own personality and your own style from that. That's what I do. And, you know, Joni Mitchell, actually, I got to say, was a huge, huge influence. Yeah. And that was the only girl that I really liked. I liked all the boys and only Joni Mitchell.
Not Stevie Nicks.
Well, I did like Stevie Nicks.
She's a rocker. I love her.
I do love her, but I didn't when I was young and little. She wasn't one of the people that influenced me then. I liked her later.
Right.
Yeah. It's interesting. Because I have an ear for tuning, so that's why Joni Mitchell captured my attention, because I make up tunes on the guitar, like I just hear them and then I pick them out. So that was some, and there was nobody else that I ever heard that did that.
Get it. Well, anyway, back with Suzanne Paris. You'll hear more later on. If you have a chance, come check her out.
Yeah.
Take care. Thanks, Suzanne.
Thank you.